Oh, you gotta react to J. Cole Applying Pressure, the off-season documentary. I'm waiting on this. I really wanted to watch this when it came out, but you know, I had to wait so I can react to it. But I just want to get straight into it. If you want me to react to a video, all you gotta do is one, be subscribed, and two, comment the video. And let's get into it.
I had a mixtape called The Warm Up. At that time, I was trying to get a deal. I felt like I was this close to getting a deal with somebody just because my music was good and I had a little bit of connections to the industry. But I had just graduated college. I was broke. Nigga, I was like struggling to pay my rent. I ain't had no job. And I was kind of being complacent because I had crazy music. And I was kind of chilling, like as if that was good enough to get me to where I needed to go.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And I had a realization. One time, nigga, I'm in a party. I'm drunk and I'm high. So I had to leave the party and go to the backyard. So I'm back there paranoid, like, oh my God. Like, nigga, I'm going through it. Nigga, life is on me. Nigga, rent. All my college friends went and got jobs. Nigga, I'm over here doing some rap shit. And these niggas walk in the backyard to come find me. And they're like, yo, we want to holler at you right quick. Bro, it turned into an intervention. These niggas was like, hey, bro, what you doing? You say you want to do this music shit, but like all you doing is really just like hanging out, partying and shit.
Mind you, one time
was like, nigga, y'all, I be with y'all niggas. Like, what the fuck are you talking about?
But bro, I got friends and family members that tell me rappers, but they don't put out no music.
It was like I was on the stage. Nigga, literally, after that, I thought about basketball. Why I ain't making basketball? I love to play.
If you think it's good, just drop, drop, drop.
You know what I mean? 22. And I'm like, nigga, why you didn't make it in basketball? Because you wasn't fucking working. You thought you'd be outside dribbling the fucking ball doing something when really niggas was in the gym with trainers, like putting in work, shooting 1,000 shots a day. Mm-hmm. And your dumb ass over there thinking you doing something, mimicking Iverson. Yeah. So it was like, yo, do you really want to look back 10, 20 years from now with this music shit and be like, the reason you didn't make it in music because you ain't put in the work. So I was like, fuck it. That was where the warm up came from. Every day, nigga, I woke up, wrote verses, made beats. So all that to say, the off season was like the same concept. Clip. Like one more time before I leave, like before I feel like I'm like fulfilled in this game, let me try to reach new heights from a skill level standpoint. Remember I told you about the 7-minute drill? Mm-hmm. Like I put myself through drills. I really try to work on my craft to like just reach new heights and push myself. So that's why I called it the off season. I know that was a long answer, but shit, nigga.
Yeah.
Hey, good answer.
I'll play you
the story.
The third joint.
A minute and a half, my boy. Do you really wanna love me forever? Off season, May 14th, baby. May 14th. I had to make sure I got that date right. Yes, sir.
This past 5 years has been a fight against comfort. I was chilling. What I noticed was with that feeling of comfort, I'm like,
he got signed
this
to
is the moment that a lot of your favorite rappers hit a crossroad where they did what the fuck they set out to do, and then the fruits of their labor started working against them. That same energy and that same like passion they put into the craft was gone, and it was replaced by like comfort and luxury.
Tried to get them shoes from RDC when RDC was giving them away for a dollar.
My life is just mad routine at this point, and I like it. So to go shoot a video, to shoot a doc, to even just come downstairs and do this, and I swear to God, bro, that's the level of like comfort slash laziness that I've reached in my life. Imagine that when applied to music and a craft and a sport that literally you can't get comfortable in.
What's up, brother?
Good morning. I knew you was up. I had to make a real decision. Are you okay with getting comfortable, chilling, mailing it in, waiting around on inspiration? If this is as high as you ever got, not career success-wise, but from a skill level, like have you wrote your best song? Did you leave no stone unturned creatively? And when I thought about that feeling, I was like, nah, I'm not cool with that.
Dang, this chapter is quick.
Told me she was pregnant. it was like almost like a clock went off. Like before life completely changed, I was like, damn, I need to refocus, wake back up and lock back in and begin the process of like the fall off, which is reaching its highest height before I feel like I can like comfortably just relax. First thing that came on my mind, I was like, yo, I gotta go back to Muhammad Fear. Right,
oh, yeah. Nah, you can look, bro. It's a whirlwind in that bitch. That shit like Mount Everest, nigga.
You ain't paying no rent, nigga. That's something for rent, niggas, nigga.
We are at the legendary Muhammad House.
Legendary.
This is where Cole stayed in when he moved to New York to go to St. John's. This house right here has been a lifeline because even when times were difficult, he struggled with certain things, like the owner treated him actually like a friend, almost like a son in a sense, so he worked with him.
I thought.
Cole.
Let me get this. You got 16?
This is 2016. Four Seals Drive had been out. I'm at the peak. And I'm like,
yeah.
Coming back here, this might be my last moment of moving how I used to move. Waking up every day dolo, just being able to write, focus on music. I came up here for like 2 months. Every morning I woke up, I had to write a verse before I can go to the city and go to the studio. And then after the studio, got to drive all the way back to Queens, wake up here, write again, record again, and then go. I remember Pharrell, one of the first times I had worked with him, he was like telling me how he had his life on a schedule. He came to the studio for certain hours. He was like, I only come to the studio from this time to this time, and I don't take shit home.
Pharrell dropped something.
I was probably 24, 25 when he said that, and I remember feeling like, damn, that's weird, because I'd be in the studio all fucking day. Like, if I stayed in the studio anything less than 12 hours before I had kids, it was a failure of a day. About 2 years into being a father, I remember like, oh, you need a schedule where your family knows that this is your time in the studio and this is the time when I'm at home on family mode. It's something that I needed to do because I'm not gonna shortcut on the family side. I put the studio in the house for that reason. It's like, I love being able to work knowing my family is right upstairs.
Got a studio in the crib. If you had enough space, we'll have a gym in the crib. Green. Oh, I thought that gym was going in. I already know what he gonna copyright me on this. Man, I thought the album was bingo drop. When did you drop this?
When you
everything
don't write
coming
for a while,
back around full circle.
You wait around for the inspiration. That's the thing that I had to cut out. Cause you can wait forever and nothing will ever come. And then when you come back, one of the main things I noticed in the process is like the trust you have in the things that you say or the things that want to be said. Like the ideas that come to your mind and want to come out and they want to be written down. You second guess them because you haven't been in the momentum of trusting and seeing results. So that first line that comes, you're like, oh, no, that's trash. I said some shit like that before. Oh, no, that's corny. Instead of just being like, yo, it's the first line. Write the shit down and trust that it'll lead you to the second line and to the third. You know what I mean? So, like, I had to just start showing up.
Can't wait to see you. I'm glad.
When I really, really fell in love with rap, it was a matter of, like, sport. I started realizing the parallel between the rapping for me and basketball. I got to operate at a high skill level, and the only way you're going to operate at a high skill level is putting in the hours, you know what I mean, the practice. So it's like, coming down to the offseason, it was the same mentality. It's like, damn, this is the time to get better. So I have to continuously come up with ways to reignite. Write one verse, do a drill, make a beat. I didn't know how long it would take, but I knew it would take time. And it literally took years of practice, writing, trying, shooting, sharpening the pen to like get it to a level that I feel like it's been like in the past couple years, like it's there.
When you dropping a track list, man, never mind. J. Cole probably go drop, it's not gonna like drop the track list.
Features,
just get to
it
when you get to it. Like get to it.
Facts, yeah.
Is that how you thought of it?
Yeah, because it was a mind state. When you put yourself in uncomfortable moments, you find out a lot about yourself. And usually you find out that you're capable of rising to that bar that's set by that uncomfortable situation. So what's something I can do? Yo, when somebody bring you a feature, say yes. I was looking at it like an opportunity for growth.
You're not in my head, Anna.
You think the era that you grew up in drove you to want to have the skill set that you got?
Hell yeah. Sure. Do you really want to look back and be like, you didn't work with nobody? You didn't have no songs with nobody? That you just cool with that? No, okay. So start saying yes to some features. Similarly, it was like that with let people know, yo, the off season, it's a boy, the fall off is coming. It's like, yo, now that the possibility of not doing this shit seems real and I'm at peace with that, don't have a regret. There's songs on here in this whole fall off era that I've been sitting on for years. Just tweaking, making better.
Mm-hmm.
Even like a middle child. That was for the fall off.
3 years ago.
But then I'm like, do you really want to wait to drop this fucking song? So I'm like, yo, fuck it. We just put out Middle Child like as a single.
Oh.
And that shit went crazy.
Yeah, so biggest hit ball, his biggest song out.
Now, normally I would just hoard that shit. And similarly, yes, I've been hoarding songs because I'm like, no, I made this for the fall off. This is too special. Now, over the years, they've gotten better. So maybe some of them have like fallen to the wayside. You know what I mean? And like, they won't make it. I still got more work to do, especially on the fall off specifically. I got a few more songs I need to write. I got more tinkering I need to do. But the vision, I finally got this shit sculpted and I can see this shit. Like, for a long time, I just knew what I wanted to do, but I just couldn't see it. It was just like, this is the most ambitious shit I've ever done. It's a patience and a trust.
Can't wait. It's gotta be the best but album yet. Got to. Awesome. You gonna see this beat later? Nice documentary. Oh, dude, next video already starting. What? That's. Dang. Hold on, I wanna check the description. See if there's anything in the description. Nope. No description, but boy, I can't wait. Boy, if I had a thought about when I get 1,000 subs, I gotta start reacting to music. So, but now I'm getting copyright. You can't even upload it. But when I get to that, boy, I'm gonna be uploading music reactions too. But we out. If you want me to react to the video, all you gotta do is comment down below. But you have to be subscribed. We out.